The world is full of fake Christians. Many who claim to be Christians are not, for they don't truly follow Jesus Christ, which is what qualifies you to be called a Christian. Many follow Moses and millions their blind shepherds. You can't follow two people or paths simultaneously. How can you claim to follow someone you disobey? Following means staying behind your guide and walking the path he has ordained while observing the instructions given. Following Christ means to obey him, and this can only be demonstrated by obedience to his sayings and teachings. When you decide to follow Jesus Christ, you have to die to self and have him take over your head so that he can guide you to his kingdom. If you decide to keep your head, then Christ is not and cannot be your head. If you love Jesus Christ, feed his sheep and lambs, not yourself, or worse, feed on the sheep as wolves do. Don't follow Moses and don't follow Elijah, for they were servants of the Lord Jesus Christ, whom they came to testify about so that we may know him and follow him. Elijah and Moses can't give life to anyone or save anyone. John 5:45-47. Do not think that I will accuse you to the Father. There is one that accuseth you, even Moses, in whom ye trust. For had ye believed Moses, ye would have believed me, for he wrote of me. But if ye believe not his writings, how shall ye believe my words? If you truly love someone, you will obey them, trust them, and do anything to please them. Disobedience and disregard is not in any way a manifestation of love, but of disrespect, loathe, and hatred. Obey Jesus Christ or you will perish, and your belief and efforts in serving are in vain. John 14:6. Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father, but by me. John 10:7-10. Then said Jesus unto them again, Verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door, by me if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out, and find pasture. The thief cometh not but for to steal, and to kill, and to destroy. I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. John 21:15-17. So when they had dined, Jesus saith to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than these? He saith unto him, Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He saith unto him, Feed my lambs. He saith to him again the second time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? He saith unto him, Yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He saith unto him, Feed my sheep. He saith unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, Lovest thou me? And he said unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things, thou knowest that I love thee. Jesus saith unto him, Feed my sheep. Matthew 17:1-5. And after 6 days Jesus taketh Peter, James, and John his brother, and bringeth them up into an high mountain apart, and was transfigured before them, and his face did shine as the sun, and his raiment was white as the light. And, behold, there appeared unto them Moses and Elias talking with him. Then answered Peter, and said unto Jesus, Lord, it is good for us to be here. If thou wilt, let us make here three tabernacles, one for thee, and one for Moses, and one for Elias. While he yet spake, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and behold a voice out of the cloud, which said, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased, hear ye him. Psalms 34:7-10. The angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear him, and delivers them. O, taste and see that the Lord is good, blessed is the man who trusts in him. O, fear the Lord, you his saints. There is no want to those who fear him. The young lions lack and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord shall not lack any good thing. When Jesus said we should fast in secret, he wasn't joking. The person who tells you that you need to let him know when you fast so that they can help you in fasting or cover you with prayers is your real enemy. He is just asking you to do so, so that he can take out the demons he has been using in controlling you to safety and then return them back into your soul after you are finished with your fast. They also hijack you in the spirit and mislead you from the truth. They work for the enemy. Obey Jesus Christ or you will perish for putting your trust on other men. Matthew 6:16-18. Moreover, when ye fast, be not, as the hypocrites, of a sad countenance, for they disfigure their faces, that they may appear unto men to fast. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou fastest, anoint thine head, and wash thy face. That thou appear not unto men to fast, but unto thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father, which seeth in secret, shall reward thee openly. Jeremiah 17:5. Thus saith the Lord, Cursed be the man that trusteth in man, and maketh flesh his arm, and whose heart departeth from the Lord. Jeremiah 17:7. Blessed is the man that trusteth in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is. Jeremiah 17:9. The heart is deceitful above all things, and desperately wicked, who can know it? When Jesus Christ said, Call no man your father on earth, he wasn't kidding. A father has authority over his children, and whatever authority that father figure is under, those who submit to him automatically brings themselves under subjection of that authority too, and we know since they are disobeying Jesus Christ, they are certainly not of him or under him. Many have perished for such ignorance and lack of understanding. Obey Jesus Christ or you will never enter his kingdom. The things people take for granted have serious spiritual implications and consequences. Matthew 23:9. And call no man your father upon the earth, for one is your father, which is in heaven. Luke 16:15. And Jesus said unto them, You are they which justify yourselves before men, but God knoweth your hearts, for that which is highly esteemed among men is abomination in the sight of God. Obey Jesus Christ so that you can withstand storms. Matthew 7:24-27. Therefore whosoever heareth these sayings of mine, and doth them, I will liken him unto a wise man, which built his house upon a rock, and the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. And every one that heareth these sayings of mine, and doth them not, shall be likened unto a foolish man, which built his house upon the sand, and the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it. Stay away from people claiming to have special anointing or grace to cunningly elevate and project themselves above others. Anointing is having the Holy Spirit, and we are all baptized by one Spirit when we believe in Jesus Christ, and this is the Spirit of Jesus Christ himself in each truly born again child of God. Jesus Christ can't contradict himself. The only reality is that their anointing is truly special, in that it's not of Jesus Christ and therefore it's inferior, a counterfeit and of the enemy, because there is nothing and nobody greater than Jesus Christ. Matthew 23:8. But be not ye called Rabbi, for one is your Master, even Christ, and all ye are brethren. Many have forsaken Jesus Christ, and therefore he has given them over to their delusions and allowed the enemy to feed them with wormwood. Repent and obey Jesus Christ so that he can give you understanding of his will and show you the way. Jonah 2:8. They that observe lying vanities forsake their own mercy. Jeremiah 15:6. Thou hast forsaken me, saith the Lord, thou art gone backward, therefore will I stretch out my hand against thee, and destroy thee, I am weary with repenting. Jeremiah 9:13-16. And the Lord saith, Because they have forsaken my law which I set before them, and have not obeyed my voice, neither walked therein, but have walked after the imagination of their own heart, and after Balaam, which their fathers taught them, therefore thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, Behold, I will feed them, even this people, with wormwood, and give them water of gall to drink. I will scatter them also among the heathen, whom neither they nor their fathers have known, and I will send a sword after them, till I have consumed them. Any person advising you to pray in the name of his God instead of that of Jesus Christ in order to get a breakthrough is introducing you into devil worship through the back door. I know of a particular individual whose testimonies revolves around how people who have prayed to his God, I call upon God of Bishop so-and-so, have suddenly become rich and through his covetousness awakening testimonies has lured many into devil worship without their knowledge. Instead of praying in the name of Jesus, people are now praying to God of so-and-so. The God of this particular individual actually is a principality in charge of wealth. Stick to Jesus Christ, for there is only one name given through which men can be saved. Repent. Acts 4:12. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men, whereby we must be saved. Luke 11:2. And he said unto them, When ye pray, say, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, as in heaven, so in earth. Covetousness and greed. The level of covetousness exhibited by many people who profess to be Christians is astonishing. Imagine a person who is even a pastor coming to your house or entering your car, and then they quietly start praying that in the name of Jesus they possess your car or your house. Now, this is the real witchcraft. The witches of the world who have never truly heard about Jesus can't themselves do that to their friends, yet people who claim to belong and serve Jesus Christ do these abominable things. We have many groups of people calling themselves churches, but whenever they meet, all they do is chant, We possess, as they pray to possess things of this world, including the neighboring plots which are already occupied by families, without caring what will happen to those families or individuals if God was to answer such prayers. Luckily, our Lord doesn't listen to such rubbish, and it's even abomination to Him. Repent. We live at a time of great wickedness where parents even tell their children when they visit their friends they should pray and possess those lands. Many people who do not know Christ or are not fully surrendered to Him have been destroyed by such witchcraft practiced by Bible-clutching witches, who then afterwards go on spreading fear and brag that it was God who cursed those victims because they didn't surrender their properties to the church or honor the so-called men of God. Repent. The whole world belongs to the Lord except for the evil systems that currently run the world and whose time has expired. The changeover will involve a thorough shaking as evil fights to stay on and those who rule darkness are overturned and overtaken. This changeover is the time of great tribulation. The Lord God Jesus Christ is swiftly coming to do away with evil, and in desperation Satan is dishing a lot of resources to people in a bid to keep them busy and unaware of the times so that they don't repent, and also to lure children of God into destruction by murmuring and coveting their neighbors who seem to be doing quite well, as others struggle. God is also working through some of His children He has called, and many do not even know their steps are being ordered of the Lord to prepare resources and safe havens that will help others during the great tribulation, and therefore nobody should covet or exhibit jealousy towards their neighbors. Numbers 21:5-6. And the people spake against God, and against Moses, Wherefore have ye brought us up out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is no bread, neither is there any water, and our soul loatheth this light bread. And the Lord sent fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and much people of Israel died. Psalms 37:23. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. Psalms 24:1. The earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell therein. Luke 12:15. And Jesus said unto them, Take heed, and beware of covetousness, for a man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. 1 Corinthians 5:11. But now I have written unto you not to keep company, if any man that is called a brother be a fornicator, or covetous, or an idolater, or a railer, or a drunkard, or an extortioner, with such an one know not to eat. 1 Corinthians 6:10. Nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortioners, shall inherit the kingdom of God. Ephesians 5:3. But fornication, and all uncleanness, or covetousness, let it not be once named among you, as becometh saints. Ephesians 5:5. For this ye know, that no whoremonger, nor unclean person, nor covetous man, who is an idolater, hath any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. 1 Timothy 3:2-4. A servant of the Lord then must be blameless, the husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, of good behavior, given to hospitality, apt to teach, not given to wine, no striker, not greedy of filthy lucre, but patient, not a brawler, not covetous, one that ruleth well his own house, having his children in subjection with all gravity. 1 Timothy 6:10. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith, and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. Hebrews 13:5. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have, for he hath said, I will never leave thee, nor forsake thee. Colossians 3:1-15. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not on things on the earth. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is idolatry, for which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience. In the which ye also walked some time, when ye lived in them. But now ye also put off all these, anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him, where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcision nor uncircumcision, barbarian, Scythian, bond nor free, but Christ is all, and in all. Put on therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, bowels of mercies, kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, longsuffering, forbearing one another, and forgiving one another, if any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. And above all these things put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful.